Hey, Comedia Balsam, I'm Gabe, and this is Bookish Pixie. So over time, I've gotten a lot of different questions about my process, whether I like to write by hand or on the computer, or what programs I use, and I figured, you know what, why not? Let's talk about it. On a basic level, I usually write on the computer. I do like to sometimes either plot or brainstorm a little bit on paper, whenever possible. That's not always an option for me, because I do have rheumatoid arthritis, and it's the worst in my right hand. Which is what I use to write. So sometimes it's not really possible for me to write for extended periods of time by hand. That said, I do that anyway sometimes when I can, and other times I'll just do it all on the computer because I'm pretty used to that too. I like to brainstorm on Evernote if I don't do it on paper, and once I feel like I have enough plot material, then I'll start plotting on Scrivener. I like to use Scrivener's corkboard feature, which allows you to write out scenes on different flashcards that are all digital. And I've talked a little bit about that before in my How I Plot video, so I'll link to that below, but that's where I'll usually start. Once I have a plot, I also do just about all of my first drafting on Scrivener. However, I also use some other programs alongside Scrivener when I'm first drafting. I like to have some kind of visualization of my progress because it makes me feel good to like visually see the progress I've made besides just like in a Word document. So I use two different programs for that. The first program is My Write Club, which you'll find online for free at www.mywriteclub.com. I like their progress tracking where you basically can customize it however you want and set up how many words, for example, you want to write, and then you'll update it as you go along and you'll see a progress bar that shows you how far you've come. My Write Club also has a writing sprint section, which I really like too. The way the writing sprint works is you can either choose a global session or a private session. If you do a global one, you'll be able to see how many words other people have written, though you won't be able to see what they're writing. And basically the way it works is there'll be a countdown of, I think it's every 25 minutes. And as the clock counts down, you write, and it'll show you how many words you've written during that session in total. And for every 100 words you write, you get a little star, and I think that's really cool. I'm easily motivated, okay? I like getting little stars. From there, I'll usually just like copy and paste what I've written into Scrivener, and I'll do that a couple times, and usually that's how I'll hit my daily goal. If I don't feel like doing that, though, I'll use Scrivener's focus mode, which will basically just dim out everything else on your desktop except the document that you're writing, so you can focus on what you're writing. And I'll also usually put up the word targets next to that so that I can see how much I'm writing as I go along. The second program I use for progress tracking is also available for free online, and you'll find that at www.pacemaker.press. The way Pacemaker works is it basically just creates different graphs that are a little more intricate than what My Write Club has. So it can show you how many words a day you've written in like a calendar format, or it can show you like a line graph of like writing this much this day and this much the next day and that much that day, etc. And again, I just like that too because I really like seeing a visualization of my work. But all of that is said and done and I have my first draft, I also do all my initial revisions in Scrivener. I like to use Scrivener's revision modes, which will basically just change the text color. So like when I'm doing my first round of edits, it'll all be red, for example. And then when I'm doing my second round of revisions, it'll be whatever, blue. And I just like doing that because, again, I'm a visual person and it shows me like the different ways that the manuscript has evolved over time and what I've added and what I've put together as like new information. And in the end, it looks really pretty and there are a lot of fun colors. And again, it just makes me feel good about like, wow, I actually got a lot done. After I've done all my revisions with my critique partners, I'll then send it off to my agent. And from there, once I start working with publishing professionals, it all goes to Word and it stays in Word. And we work on revisions through track changes. And that, in a nutshell, is my writing process. So that's what I got for today. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to subscribe and comment, and I'll see you all soon.